Terry Talks with Terry Gillis.
Hi, everyone. Welcome to another Terry Talk. This week, we're going to continue our conversation about the grand reopening. We're seeing COVID cases coming way down. We're seeing more and more people stepping up and getting vaccinated. We're seeing businesses starting to be able to reopen. Seems like life's coming back a little bit. It's exciting and it's hopeful. And of course, most recently, most of you probably read this or heard about it, that the CEO of Morgan Stanley, one of the big investment banks in New York City, recently came out and told his staff that he'd be very disappointed if they all had not found their way back to the office by Labor Day, by September 6th of this coming year. If those didn't make it back, they'd probably be having a conversation, not about their employment, but about their compensation. How do you like that one? And he went on to say, and I want to quote this correctly, returning to the office was particularly important for junior members of staff who were training on the job. The office is where we teach, where our interns learn, and that's how we develop people, where you build all the soft cues that go with having a successful career that just aren't about Zoom presentations. Direct quote from him. So I wanted to bring in Coca-Cola Classic. Many of you may have heard of this, some of you may have not. I'll give you the quick backstory on it. Back in April of 1985, yes, this dates me, I was around for this, Coca-Cola introduced a new form of Coke called New Coke, informally. And the reason being is up until 1985, Coke had been losing the cola wars. Pepsi was eating their lunch, because they had consumers focusing on taste. And so Coke thought they had to completely revisit their formula for Coke. It was an abysmal failure. Some of you who are alive at the time will remember this. And they had to come back with Coca-Cola Classic, which was the original formula. This eventually, the new Coke eventually died a death by 2002. So what the heck does this have to do with the grand reopening? Well, this is a little bit like working from home. That debate that's currently raging. Coke focused on the wrong question. The question they focused on was taste. Instead of thinking that new Coke, that is sweeter, would rue the day, the right question to ask would have been, if we take away Coca-Cola and give people new Coke, would they accept it? They never asked the contrarian or contradictory information that was required. And people revolted. Big time. So with respect to the work from home hype, don't ask, do you want to work from home? I think the more important question is, what is it about working from the office, which up until March of 2020 was seemingly fine, what is it about that that's now getting in the way? As Bazerman and Chu state in their 2006 Harvard Business Review article, Decisions About Blinders, you need to create a devil's inquisitor, not a devil's advocate. Devil's advocate will entrench their position. Devil's inquisitor asks questions, contrarian questions, getting to information that is not obvious, that maybe contradicts the position of the day, which I'd argue right now seems to be work from home is the awesome thing to do. Fundamentally, people don't like change. We forced it on them back in March and April of 2020. Now their own confirmation bias, I argue, is supporting the position that working from home or working in a hybrid environment is better. Why don't we ask the question, what would I lose versus what would I gain from going back to the office? So I think David Solomon, CEO of Goldman Sachs, again, investment bank, New York City, says, I do not think for a business like ours, which is innovative, collaborative, and apprenticeship culture, the work from home culture is not ideal for us. And it's not a new normal. It's an aberration that we're going to correct as soon as possible, Goldman Sachs CEO. So ultimately, it's about flexibility, and it's about value creation, and it's about asking for that contrarian or contradictory information. I think that's critical to our argument. Our next Terry Talk, we're going to talk about, continue our conversation about the Great Reopening. And the next one, we're going to talk about the importance of trust. So stay tuned for that. And we'll look forward to chatting with you again soon.